Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're good. Today I'm gonna share with you my luxury bag purchases that turned out not as good as I thought. I'm gonna explain to you why I don't think that there's like the best purchases for me and share with you, you know, my experience, and hopefully you're gonna learn something. So let's start. The first thing that I'm gonna show to you, the first bag, I mean, it's kind of a clutch from Pinko. This thing is relatively expensive for such tiny bag, if you can call it like that. So the thing is, when I bought it, I was like, oh my god, it's so cool, you know, just turn it to the just wear it to your hand and you can easily go, and it's, you know, easy as that. It's really convenient, but it's not as convenient as I thought. First of all, quality after just a few wearings, that's what happened. Of course, you can fix it like relatively quickly and easy, but still, even if I cut it or went to like a special place where they fix, you know, such stuff like that, it still kind of wasn't that good. Also, with the time, unfortunately, the color of like gold kind of turned out away only on this thing for some reason. Like, all this gold pieces still looks the same, however, yeah, still not cool, you know. Also, what I realized, it's not that convenient to wear it just like that, because if you put here more than just a phone or a case or just a card, just one of the three things, for some reason it starts to open like relatively slow, but still it can open and you can lose something. So you need kind of to walk, you know, first of all, hold it in your hand like this, and also sometimes check that it's, you know, closed. So kind of in the end, it wasn't that perfect for me. Moreover, I saw that I will be able to wear it, you know, to any occasion, because it's just a small pouch and, you know, small bag, what can be easier? Well, not, because it's such a leather, like a shiny one. You cannot really wear it with like each outfit, with everything, and with sneakers, it looks also kind of funny. So yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I'm still wearing this. It's not like it's the worst thing that I bought in my life. Trust me, there are worse things, but yeah, for example, if after, like, you would ask me, like, after a year I bought it, will I buy it again? Probably not. But again, it wasn't, like, you know, worst investment in my life. The second bag, I'm not sure, like, if it's luxury. I think it's still kind of a luxury bag, because 300 euros for a brand, for a shoulder bag, it's still expensive, because you can go and buy Furla for, I don't know, 150, and so for me it's already an expensive bag. So this is a Michael Kors bag, and I actually really love this bag, because it's really easy to wear, the color is perfect, it suits to, you know, any occasion, perfect to go for a trip, you know, with this bag, because it has a lot of space here inside and all of that. But the only one thing that I'm like disappointed in this bag is that with the time it kind of lost the shape of the bag. How to show it to you guys. See, like, if you see from this angle, you won't able to see this. But if you see from the side, if you look from the side, I mean, then you can see that it's kind of, you know, it lost its shape. So from one side, I mean, it's kind of, it happens with the bag, but on another side, I'm not sure that, for example, next time I will invest in this bag, I will probably wait for sales and maybe then invest for, I know, Tory Burch, for example, because there was more harder leather. And again, I know this is like soft material and it should kind of lose a little bit the shape. But again, it's kind of intense, you know, it's kind of intense. And I was just a little bit disappointed, because still, as I said, you can buy a cheaper bag for, you know, Furla with a like harder leather, and it still kind of looks better with the time. For example, because I have a bucket bag from Furla, and it looks just the same. No matter how often I wear that, that even I wear it when I was raiding, you know, it still looks the same. This bag, unfortunately, with the time, with the shape. So if you're thinking to buy a Michael Kors bag, which is like a little bit more softer leather, just make sure that you think ahead that it can lose, you know, a shape of it. So yeah, just make sure you think before you invest your money. The next bag is a luxury bag. It's actually really beautiful. My favorite color is, if you have seen my previous video about my best luxury bags purchases, then you know that I love blue and this is not an exception. This is a Marc Jacobs, and I love this bag and I wear it a lot, especially in the summer, you know, like this. It's so really, it's beautiful, it suits for so many reasons and so many outfits and, you know, in general occasions. However, because we're talking today about not perfect bags, you know, like not perfect purchases, here's like one, I would say for me personally, a huge minus. Here's no chain. When I bought this bag, I saw that there's like a chain inside, but there is no chain inside. I was just like, I don't know why I saw this. Like, I have no idea. I haven't checked it when I bought it. And of course, I mean, I could go to the shop, I could get it back, but I just love the color, I love the size, I like, you know, the general idea of this bag. So I'm still wearing this often, don't get me wrong, I wear it a lot. But just for me, the one minus of this bag, I was thinking there was at least some chain you can put, you know, and wear it also like a shoulder or something like that, but there's none. Again, it's not a problem, but for me it was kind of a minus, because here we're talking about, you know, like, not best purchases. So I would love if here would be like some sort of chain to, like, able also to wear it with, like, through the shoulder. But yeah, again, just think about, if you want something like that, make sure you know it, that it's not always convenient, you know, to walk with a bag like this and hold it in the hand, maybe for a short amount of time, for like go to the bar or something like that, it's perfect. But if you're thinking to buy such a bag and thinking that you can go the whole day, you know, through, you know, new city, going to the trip with such bag, no guys, it's not that convenient, because you kind of tire it in the end after a few hours to hold the bag like this. So if it's like the bag for the special occasions, go to the bar, something like that, it's perfect. But if you're thinking to wear it more often, then it's not, because as I said, you kind of get tired, and also especially in the summer, you're not gonna, like, you not want to wear it like this, because we all human and we sweat, and with the sweat you can damage leather, obviously. So again, you kind of 99% of the time you need to wear it just like and hold it in your hands, which is not that perfect. Another bag that I love, and I actually still wear it, but I haven't really understood the minus before I wear it, like, before I was wearing this for like a few times. So this bag, you probably, maybe not actually everyone knows this brand, but for example in Germany and in America it's really popular. This bag is from Bali. It's called a doctor bag, because you know, if you wear it through the shoulder, it literally looks like a doctor bag from the 20th century, I guess. I'm really bad with the history, but yeah, it looks like a doctor bag. But if you put this shoulder thing chain down, then it's a simple bag, more like Louis Vuitton, I would say. And it's really cool, it's really big, you know, it also closes here in front, it's not easy to open, it's a zip, there's a huge amount of space inside, I can put my laptop inside as well. So in each aspect, kind of, you know, it's good. And you think, like, why, what is wrong with this bag? Well, I also thought like that for the first few times, but then as soon as I put a little bit more stuff here inside than just a phone and the wallet, I realized how heavy is that. The minus of this bag is that it's heavy. First of all, the whole bag in general is heavy, kind of, despite the fact it's a soft leather. But the heaviest thing here is actually the this chain here. It's so heavy, it's just ridiculous. It looks really nice and nothing special, but actually it's like, it's heavy, you know, it's really, really heavy. And so if you have something, I don't know, even a laptop inside, it's really like a sport exercise, trust me, because if you lift it like up and down, or you just, you know, wear it in the hand, guys, it's heavy. It's literally heavy. It's like a few kilos directly. And yeah, like I'm sometimes take it for the trips. I put more stuff and wear it to the shoulder, and then it's convenient because, you know, there's like huge space to put some stuff and take it with you. It's more like I would say a Louis Vuitton shop or something like that. But again, a minus, just make sure you check it when you buy the bag, because after even a few minutes, if you just hold it like that in the air, as do I right now, you just feel it's heavy. So yeah, I love this bag just because it's so, you know, kind of unusual and beautiful chain, and you know, the quality, the leather, it's so perfect. However, again, the minus, it's heavy. So yeah, make sure you actually, you know, kind of try the bag when you buy and invest, because yeah, I wasn't thinking that the bag can be that heavy. But again, I'm still wearing this, I still like this, I'm just sharing with you, you know, my experience. And yeah, is it good or not? If you're thinking to buy a really similar bag, make sure it's not heavy. And the last bag I'm gonna share with you today is a bag from amazing brand, which produce really, 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 really beautiful shoes and bags. And I cannot explain you how disappointed I am and how unhappy I am, because I love this bag just unbelievably. I loved it like so much. When I bought it, I was wearing this like relatively often, but still not each day. And it's broken. It's broken, and it's not broken in the way, it's like damaged or something. I'm gonna show it and you will understand what I mean. So this is a Valentino bag. I love this bag, I love this color, I love the leather, the quality is amazing, you know, all these accessories here, it looks perfect, you know, the open and close side, you know, looks perfect, the size is amazing, there's just like one huge pocket inside, so you can actually take a lot of stuff with you. Everything is amazing, you can wear it as a clutch and as a shoulder, but I am a little bit shocked of the quality of the hangers, because as you can see, it is broken for the current moment. Obviously, I'm gonna bring it to Valentino, and this is actually how the whole idea of this video came, to explain you guys that, you know, not each purchase and not each brand actually is perfect, you know, there's like a minuses. And so from one side, you can be, what can be better than this, you know, chain and everything like that. Well, yeah, it looks good, but look at this, it's not broken. I haven't, you know, I don't know like how to explain it. It looks like actually it's just the glue inside, you know, see? This just looks like the glue inside dried. That's why I took it up. And obviously it doesn't hold anymore the chain, because there is no glue or whatever it should be inside. I'm not the producer of the bag to know for 100%. So in other words, of course I can fix it by myself. You put inside, you pull this, let's say like this leather tongue inside, and it still looks kind of as a new, you know, everything is fine. But as soon as you wear it properly, after a few times, if you like walk a little bit, what happens? Obviously, this leather piece just takes off, because again, there is no proper glue inside, and the bag is broken kind of. So you obviously cannot wear it properly. So yeah, This is a huge disappointment because this bag costs enormous amount of money, and I was expecting a little bit better quality. And again, I know it's not like the bag is broken, that you cannot wear it at all. Of course, it's kind of easy fix, but still, you know, the idea that the bag that costs like a lot of money, we all know how Valentino's bags are expensive, that such thing happens after, I would say, like 2 years of not wearing it. Trust me guys, I wasn't wearing it like each day. I was wearing only this during like warm days and not each day, because I obviously have other bags also to wear. So like, you get what I mean. I wasn't wearing like constantly, non-stop. I never wear with such bags something heavy, because there's obviously no space also to put something heavy inside to make it breaking. Because also, you can see, as I said earlier, it just looks like something with the glue. So yeah, this is one of this situations where I was like, okay, I invest money, I think I'm gonna, you know, have this bag for a long time. However, as you can see, not each investment is worth it, and this is like situation where I'm really unhappy and disappointed, because I love this bag. I love how convenient it's for my outfits, for, you know, my lifestyle, that it's used for me perfectly. But I know such stuff happens, but it's just not cool, you know? So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and you also understand that I'm a human, I also do some mistakes, and I buy not always the perfect stuff. And as I said earlier, I love all of these bags, I'm still wearing them. This is more a video about like to show that, you know, some purchases are not perfect, and despite the fact that actually these bags are not perfect for me, or at least I found some minuses in my purchases, it doesn't mean that for you they're not gonna be perfect, you know. And I'm just sharing with you my own experience, what I realized with the time, that next time, for example, I wouldn't buy it, or I will be more careful with the choice or something like that. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe and put some likes, I will really appreciate it, and see you in the next one. Bye.